I'm here with Panos Panay in New York, and you can probably guess from what's behind us, right, why we're here.
Yeah,
We Panos just did a whole bunch of announcements around Surface 2, Surface 2 Pro. But what I wanted to talk about is take us on the journey, like from when the last product shipped. What have you been doing? I know you've been sat around at home, like watching movies.
Yeah, we don't do much.
Take us on the journey.
This has been a super, super roller coaster ride, from an emotional one to a technology one. People, we've been growing the team. Mm-hmm. We have a vision for amazing products to come. And when we shipped the original Surface, it was weird because it was kind of like a pause in the entire roadmap of products to come. You don't stop a product and then start a new one. You're developing so many things at the same time. And when you have such an awesome team like we do in Redmond across Windows and other services, and then, you know, specifically the Surface team, you're lucky to have that sort of dedication to make that happen.
So tell us a little bit about that team. You said you've been growing the team. What does that mean? More engineers, more designers?
Yeah, everything.
What skills does it take to make this thing happen?
It takes product makers. We have to think like product makers. And, you know, I know it's kind of a little bit of a fluffy word. You're probably not going to find that on a job title, but that's what it takes. People that love the product and that want to make great things for people
to
use.
Right? Artisans.
There's
the
a lot.
I see in your labs, it's crafts.
We have craftsmen. We have marketers that just love it, and they are product makers themselves. We have great engineering talent that it looks at every detail and can even be clunky about it, but they know what product is right for people, and they make it. Yeah.
So you talked about your 5'8". You look much taller than 5'8". I just want to say that.
I feel like I should be 6'3".
So tell me about.
I always felt like I should be 6'3". That's what I felt like.
You'd be a good basketball player.
I'd be awesome. Like, I mean, I've got a massive crossover. It's mad. It's crazy.
So tell me about the kickstand. Like, as a piece of engineering, you know, you created a whole video around this kickstand. You're clearly passionate about these things.
Well, it was more about how it felt as a product. And, you know, if you add a tacky add-on feature to a product, you've destroyed the concept of, you know, being something premium or being something that, you know, people know is great. And it wasn't about the kickstand, and it's all about the kickstand. I think it's somewhat iconic at this point, no doubt. But it was more about making sure every nook and cranny of that thing felt like it was amazing. It was one of the most dangerous moving parts on the product. And it is the same part of the product that transforms it from a tablet to the next thing you're going to use it as. And if we didn't get that perfect, this product can't exist the way it does today. Yeah.
So just let's go back to that journey. Can you?
Yeah.
There must be highs and lows in this journey. There must be a moment where you say this thing's going to be awesome. There must be moments of despair where you think.
You have to believe in everything you're making, and you don't want to do it blindly. And so in the first run, going at Surface. The first couple of years were, you know, kind of in a vault and done secretly and for good reason.
I know.
Great reason.
Like, you didn't talk to me for 2 years. What happened?
That's a hard to explain. And I'd still like you, though. I mean, look how close we're standing.
I think this is a full-on bromance here.
I know. But as you go through that process, you're learning to, you know, craft a great product for what you've intended to do. But now you get the opportunity to listen to customers, get feedback, continue to tweak and romance your product, if you will, to make sure it's what it needs to be for people to use and get stuff done. And I think that's what we did. But that comes with a lot of emotional turns. It comes with a lot of commitment and hard work from an amazing team that's willing to let their product get to market and then come off and get the next product going, regardless of how great or not great it's doing. Knowing you have a vision is the most important part.
And some of that feedback must have been tough around, you know, give me more power.
A lot of it. Oh yeah, a lot of it's tough, but a lot of it's also very helpful. And, you know, it depends on who's giving it.
Right.
It really does. I think, like in anything, if it's coming from the heart and it's for the right reasons, there's nothing better than feedback. You know, and there's times when that's not the case at all, believe me. And there's times when it is, and it's meaningful. And I don't think it's hard as much as it is wonderful to make sure we're able to get as much feedback as possible. You know, we feel like we're making devices here with the whole company. And the Surface team is out there doing that on a daily basis and partnering across the company to make this come to life. And as we transform as a devices and services company, what better way to do it with a product like Surface?
And that's one of the things I really noticed from the presentation you gave, is this is, it's more than just the device, right?
Yeah.
It's the it's the coming together of whether it's SkyDrive or Skype, all of the pieces of the company.
I tried to. We tried to. Like, a big part of this was designing a product that brought all of Microsoft together. I don't think there's anything more powerful than for that for people or our company. And so that's what I love going after.
So I have two final questions for you. First one is, what are you most proud of about this set of products? Because it's not just the devices anymore. There's a whole bunch of awesome accessories. So what are you most proud of? And then my second one is, tell me a secret, buddy.
Okay.
Like, tell me a secret about Surface.
You're asking unfair questions. So let me give you unfair answers. Is that right?
I guess so.
Look, I have four kids. If you came to me and said, pick the right kid, I would do my best to tell you to go away. You know, when you ask the same conversation, like, don't make me pick the favorite part of one of my kids. Like, they're all beautiful. And I think this product is a reflection of the entire team, and I love everything about it. So there's an unfair, cheesy answer. Here's a secret. A secret. You want a secret? Man.
Come on. I know you have secrets in that.
All right. Here's the deal. This is true.
Hit me with it.
Stevie is a lot smarter than he looks.
Stevie Batiche.
Yeah. He's a genius. Stevie, I hope you see this. I think you're a genius. Now, just so you know, he's also a major pain in the ass. Okay?